Recording has started.
Hello all, this is Pritesh Chikatwar from engineering team. I work in Red Hat as a software engineer. I'm in Rivy team. So today we are going to discuss about the cluster upgrade feature. This is one of the feature in Rivy product. Let's deep dive on this feature. So today's agenda for cluster upgrade will be like, we'll be seeing introduction to the cluster, why cluster upgrade requires, and what are the prerequisites for cluster upgrade to make it happen, and cluster upgrades in UI, obviously. So if I talk about the introduction of cluster, so you can see from this picture, the cluster consists of storage domain, logical network, CPU types, and host. Host act as a hypervisor, which dynamically creates VMs and all. So the gray square boxes are physical objects, and red ones are virtual objects. Basically, cluster consists of hosts, storage domains, logical networks, and many other things. Host is also referred as a OAuth node or just a node. It is basically an operating system that is based on CentOS, and that is simply provides that is a machine which acts as a hypervisor in an OAuth environment. This OS contains only the packages that requires machines to act as an hypervisor, not anything else. Even the Red Hat Hyperconverged setup we do with Cockpit UI. So this host contains Cockpit RPMs as well, packages as well, to make it have support through Cockpit deployment. Okay, why cluster upgrade? So the cluster upgrade is required basically because this is why cluster upgrade, basically why it's from UI. So why? Because if you do a manual things, like if you want to perform many of the manual steps, there are manual steps. So you need to do series of manual steps to perform this cluster upgrade, like dropping the VM, starting the VM after upgrade, handling the migration of VM. Basically in an OAuth node or just an host, there are hundreds of VMs. You cannot manually stop particular VMs, one VM, two VMs. This will take a lot of time. And after stopping the VMs, again, you need to start the VMs and migration of the VM. You need to move cluster to the maintenance mode because you cannot make highly available a VM. And this feature basically to provide ease for the cluster upgrade feature. And because of that, it is implemented with the help of UI. Okay, the prerequisite for this cluster upgrade is you need to enable the latest repos on the host because the latest packages gets updated on that host. Otherwise, there is no point in making cluster upgrade without enabling the repos, right? So in the stopping the GRUB session if anything is processed. In this feature, there is one feature enhancement is required, like stopping the GRUB session if there exists on this product. GRUB session is basically replicating of data geographically. So we are not implemented that stopping the GRUB session in present 4.4.1 release. In future enhancement, it will be there. And next, check for the brick quorum is met for the volume. So this is basically when you have brick quorum means when you have distributed replicated volumes, so you might need there might be possibility of syncing of data from one host to another host. So if there is a mismatch in data, so there's basically a loss of quorum. So you should check whether there is a loss of quorum or not. So this basically is taken care by engine. It is written because See, basically, when you start the upgrade, basically takes usually takes more than 30 minutes, 20 minutes. So you don't want to fail your upgrade just because of quorum loss or what. So that's just for an recheck. We just added this, but internally it checks for this as well. And engine FQDN should not contain in host password. So this means that so assume you have your engine FQDN is Ritesh, so not tendril.lab.vegad.com. So you should in your password should not be like redhat.123 or tendril123. So it's better, it's recommended that you should not use FQDN literals in your password. Yeah, cluster upgrade in UI. So to navigate in UI. So this is the admin portal of Rivy. When you log in, you need to go to the compute cluster and click on upgrade. So you have upgrade added upgrade icon. When you click on that upgrade icon, you will see a pop-up window where you will get option to select host. So these will show list of hosts present in that particular cluster. And you will see a bit of information over how many virtual machines are there, how many things. The Tendril 14 has one virtual machine, Tendril 15 has zero virtual machine, Tendril 16 has one virtual machine. You need to select the host which you want to upgrade. So I selected three hosts. So these three hosts are upgraded one at a time. And it's recommended that you don't select a host which is in down status. It's recommended that you select the host which is in up status, because basically down status host considered as loss of quorum because it's already down. There should be mismatch of data with other host. So we will see the second tab in pop-up window is select different option to set before cluster upgrade starts. So there are different options like stop pin the VMs. Pin the VMs are the VMs which are pinned for the particular host. Like those VMs always run on that V host only. So you have option to whether to stop those VMs or let continue running. And second option is upgrade timeout. So this timeout is in minutes. So default is 60. So this means that the time taken for individual host to update. So if it crosses 60 minutes, then this upgrade will fail. Okay, then next option is check upgrade. So this is basically what happens is before the upgrade process start from the engine, it will check for the latest update. If you tick the checkbox and reboot after upgrade. So this is basically like when the upgrade is finished. You want to reboot the host or simply keep it in down state only, or you want to manually start the host. It's up to you. It's an extra option it's provided. And use maintenance policy. So if you click tick this checkbox, during the upgrade process, cluster has been moved to the cluster maintenance mode. So this makes virtual machines cannot start unless they are highly available, because during the upgrade process there might be chances that VMs are migrating from one host to another host. So moving cluster to maintenance mode makes it the limitation that VM must be highly available to make it use. Okay. So this is like in this second tab we have tooltip option like eye icon you can see there. So clicking on that it will provide more info on that particular option. So the last stepper in this dialog box is like confirmation of cluster upgrade that how many hosts are updating. So you can see I selected in the first host three host. I marked the three hosts, so that's why you are seeing here three hosts are selected, will be upgraded one at a time during cluster upgrade. Yeah, thank you. This is a don't think 102. And thanks for all the contributors who helped me in making this feature complete. Thank you, Martin Nikas. Thank you, Martin Parina. Thank you, Govinda Das. If any questions, you can mail us at users@overt.org, or you can mail us particularly to me, rchikatw@red.com. Yeah, thank you.